Hello, hello everyone, how are you all? I hope you are doing well at home. Welcome back to my class. As you all know that we are revising now SA2 syllabus. So please note down the SA2 syllabus, children. The Tale of Benjamin Bunny, SA2, first lesson. Hurt No Living Things poem. Fourth lesson, Pinocchio. Sixth lesson, The Lost Camel. Then poem, Thousands and Thousands, SA2. Next comes ninth lesson, A Tiny Seed, SA2. And then 11th lesson, Home Sweet Home, SA2. So children, please count how many lessons are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there are 5 lessons and 2 poems. Thousands and Thousands and Hurt No Living Things. So total 7 lessons you have to learn, children. Alright, so let us see today. First lesson, The Tale of Benjamin Bunny. So children, please take out page number 4. Yeah, so this warm-up activity is not necessary. Let us see here the detailed explanation of the first lesson. One morning, as little Benjamin Bunny sat on a river bank. So what is bank here? Your bank is nothing but a raised area of ground along the edge of a river. So near the river, who was sitting? The little Benjamin Bunny was sitting, and he heard the trit-trot, trit-trot of a pony. Pony is nothing but here a small horse's noise. So a horse carriage was coming along the road. So who was driving that? It was driven by Mr. McGregor, and beside him sat Mrs. McGregor. So they passed. As they passed, so little Benjamin set off to visit his cousins. He decided to visit his cousins. So what are the names of the cousins here? Flopsy, Mopsy, Cottontail and Peter. They lived in the wood at the back of Mr. McGregor's garden. Then what happened here? The next day, old Mrs. Rabbit had once told the little bunnies that you can go to the fields or down the lane, but you should not go to Mr. McGregor's garden. So Flopsy, Mopsy and Cottontail, they were very good little bunnies and they obeyed also. But here Peter is a naughty person. Peter did not listen to her mother. Then that morning when little Benjamin came round back of the fir tree, he fell on top of his cousin Peter. So Peter was sitting by himself sadly and he said that, "Why are you sad and where are your clothes?" said little Benjamin to Peter. And as he was dressed in a red pocket cotton handkerchief. So Peter whispered back and said all the story that Mr. McGregor chased me in the garden and took off my clothes, hat and shoes. Then, so little Benjamin sat down beside his cousin and said, "Now Mr. and Mrs. McGregor have gone out. It's the right time to get your clothes back." So Peter smiled a naughty smile and the two bunnies walked into the garden hand in hand. And there they saw the scarecrow, which was wearing Peter's coat and shoes and an old woolen cap of Mr. McGregor's. Then what happens? Can you guess, children? Yeah, then afterwards they have taken the shoes and then squeezed the clothes as it rained last night. Then they took out the pocket handkerchief and in that they kept onions for her mother to give a surprise. So they went with that pocket handkerchief and they, as they are coming out of the garden, they took or plucked a bunch of flowers. Okay, and then they started walking towards the other end of the garden. Then they saw here a cat sitting near the basket. So by suddenly what happened here, they stopped and they hid under the basket because they will fear of a cat. Then the cat was looking here and there and stretched herself and came and sniffed at the basket because the onion smell has come out of the basket. So the cat loved the smell of that basket of the onions. Then little Benjamin and Peter started crying. Then the cat sat there for a long time. Then the pitter-patter and some bits of mortar came out in the evening from the above wall. Then the cat looked up. Suddenly, who came here? Mr. Benjamin Bunny came out. And what he did? He heard the little bunnies crying softly. Then he jumped off of the wall and onto the cat. And then he flung the cat into the garden house and locked the door. And the cat was too surprised to scratch him. Then Mr. Old Bunny came back to the basket and pulled out little Benjamin and Peter by the ears. Then they took out the handkerchief full of onions and as well as flowers and marched the naughty bunnies out of the garden. Then they came to their house and Peter gave to his mother the onions and the flowers. So she was very happy with that wonderful gifts that he brought for her. Then she did not scold him and for being a naughty bunny, because she was so happy that he found his shoes and coat. So that's why she did not scold Peter. All right, children. So this reading part we will see in the next video. So till then, you just go through the reading practice and learn the question answers as well. Okay, children, so take care. Allah Hafiz.